Hello, everybody. So today, I'm going to be showing you how you can add Lethal Ape type elevators to your game. All credit to Stella, even though I literally hate her, because she banned me from her Discord server for me asking if I could take inspiration off Lethal Ape. But I still respect her a little bit. So, still have faith in her. But this is how to add Lethal Ape type elevators like this. All the scripts are... See, I added credits to elevator button client trigger, or no player account. So you're going to want to go to Blender, and you're going to want to shift A, mesh, cube, go to the side view, and then make it like this. I'd say... A, line selector, control B, scroll wheel, to level, and it'll look like this, pretty good, and then subdivide it, and then shade smooth, and then we're going to want to do this, cylinder, and then just drag it like this. This is going to be the button for me. What I want to do is I'm going to take this, and I'm going to control C and V, and then I'm going to scale it down a lot, and then I'm going to do this. So, you can see, I'm just going to size it up a bit. It's like this. What I'd recommend doing is A, and then faces, loop tools, smart UV project on that, and then just S, and then join, make these, both of these, make them have their own texture, or like the little line, and then this, control J. You can have, make them have their own texture. I'm gonna just bevel the button. I think it looks better beveled. So, little bevel button. Like that. And then it looks good. That looks pretty good. I don't mind those little lines. That actually looks better. So now, you can do A control, or crap. A control J. Or, not control J, but. Then you can do file, export. And then call it like elevator pad or something. And then I'm gonna go and put it in my project. So, elevator, where is it? And then, export. And then you can see, imports. And then, I'm going to put an elevator button right here. So, I'm going to rotate this. And then scale down. And then bring it over here. And then I'm just gonna put in the thing or whatever. Alright, so now I'm just gonna put some textures on it. So now you can see decent button. UV unwrapping came in handy. So now, on the actual button, the reason I wanted to separate this is because of the button. So, on the button, add. All the scripts will be in the Discord server, by the way. Link in the description. So add a button. Just search up button. And then go elevator button trigger client. And then you're gonna do for EB, you're gonna drag elevator right here, or whatever had this, whatever had the elevator button client script. So now we're gonna do hand colliders. And then open up your gorilla player, drag both of these in here. Just like that. So now, once you do that, so once you do that, it should be set up from there. Add player account real quick. Well, Chris, it's still a dev. All right. So webhook link, create a new Discord server. And then do create my own for me and my friends, and then name it, I'll name it like PF3 elevator player. Elevator player count. All right. All right. Well, have K. Okay. TV14's cook sniffers. Okay. So you're going to want to go over here, server settings. Integrations, webhooks, create a webhook, and this player counter, and then do a copy webhook URL. You can customize this if you want, but it doesn't really matter. All right, so it changes. So now you're going to do copy webhook URL, and you're going to put this in here, just like that. So now, you go. It's gonna take a while for me. If it takes a while for you, nice, we're on the same side. Alright, so now it's gonna do its thing. So. So now, you're going to want to, So then, you're going to want to bring your gorilla player up and to your elevator. I'm going to have to maneuver my way around my monster. It's right there. So. Give me struggle. I don't care. Dude, why do you have to go over there? He's after the player. He's glazing over there. All right, guess what? No, because guess what? Guess what's stinky? Bye bye. All right, now I can actually. So, take your player. And then. Basically, what the player count script does, I think, is. Sends a message. Player is not using mods or the application is genuine. So, it'll send that. Okay. So, now, take your, like, right hand or something. Put it up. Just bring it to the button. And then, I think this should work. Oh. Mesh collider, convex is trigger. That's why. Drag that into elevator. Sorry. But now, should be able to do this. Pretty goofy. It works. So, don't ask why I put Funky Town. I just liked it. So now, I'm just gonna drag player. Also, if you wanna add another elevator button, just duplicate the elevator button. And these are all the scripts. They are literally straight from Lethal Ape. I have not edited them, other than giving credits as headers. That's all I've edited, but that's really it for what I've done to the scripts. So, straight from Lethal Ape. Again, like the description for the scripts. Mesh, glider, convex, is trigger. So you can see it reports automatically. So I'm just gonna take the right hand and to add this. So I'm just gonna delete that. Anyway, yeah, that's really it. That's how you add a good elevator like Lethal Ape to your game. Okay, bye.